honor Oliver and Susan Stark as one of the honorees for this year's Jazz on the Screen. Oliver and Susan have been major donors to our programs, and they are part of San Marino Community Church, which has been a supporter of Friends Indeed for many decades. Oliver and Susan have felt a deep connection to the women's room, and Susan has been a liaison for the church and Friends Indeed. So we hope you enjoy this video and learn more about Oliver and Susan Stark, and we're thrilled that they are one of the honorees for this year's Jazz on the Screen.
Well, I wanted to start off by saying a little bit about how we got involved with Friends Indeed to begin with. And it was actually through our church, San Marino Community Church. And they've been supporting Friends Indeed for 12 years. And additionally, the church's foundation has been as well. And I had the privilege of being the liaison between our church and Friends Indeed for a number of years and got to know Reverend Burns and now Rabbi Grader. And we have just been so impressed with Friends Indeed and all that it does that we've made it one of our personal priorities as well. And I really love the way Friends Indeed really reaches out and gets involved with the organizations, the individuals that partner with them. I know in the case of our church, they have been involved in a number of special events, and I particularly like the time when Rabbi Grader came and played the drums at our contemporary worship service.
One of the things that really moves me about Friends Indeed's mission really is what they do for the homeless people in the greater Los Angeles area and Pasadena in particular. We moved to Los Angeles in 1993, and I would go out for jogs in the afternoon after work, and I would run across a particular homeless man on the streets of Pasadena. And from time to time, I would offer to buy him a meal to help him along. Unfortunately, over the 27 years that we have lived in Pasadena, the problem doesn't seem to have been totally solved. One thing that I really like is the fact that Friends Indeed has a compassion. They're resourceful, they have great volunteers, and they reach out and try to help people who are on the verge of losing their homes or people that have lost their homes and need a place to live.
You know, I find that Friends Indeed truly walks the talk. They fulfill their mission of doing together what we cannot do alone. And they have so many wonderful programs, but I think the one that really moves me the most is the street outreach. This is a program where they proactively have a team that go out on the streets of Pasadena and reach out to the chronically homeless to build relationships, to build trust, and to ultimately find these folks permanent housing. They follow up. They don't just check the box when folks get a place. They make sure that they're able to maintain that. They provide supportive services. And if there are any challenges, they help resolve them. And I think what's a true testament to the success of this organization is that some of these former clients become volunteers themselves in some of the Friends Indeed programs.
If there's people that are brand new to learning about Friends Indeed, I think it's important for them to understand the different services that Friends Indeed offer. Part of our hope for the future of Friends Indeed is the expansion of their services. From time to time, we have had conversations with Rabbi Grader. It would be wonderful if there's a way that expansion could occur and more services could be provided to more people. We think that that's really an important thing and would like to see that growth continue for the group Friends Indeed.
This organization is 126 years old, almost as old as the Tournament of Roses. And they have been out meeting needs in the community all that time. And not just the tangible needs of shelter and food and things like that, but intangible things like providing respect and dignity and building a sense of community. Again, truly friends indeed. How remarkable it has been that Friends Indeed has been able to adapt and be flexible during this time of COVID-19 and still figure out ways to provide services and help the people, our neighbors, who are even more at risk now during this time of the virus.
For us, it's really an honor. It's nothing that we would really ever expect. We're just trying to do, you know, our part, help people out. We just are honored to be able to share what we have with others and make their lives better.